Hello, this is Ethan Walsh. Isn't it fantastic to look up at the stars during the night and think about what's up there? It amazes me how beautiful the sky is, and I'm sure it amazes you too. Well, on this new TV series, we'll be discovering everything that's up there. We'll be discovering all of the universe. Welcome to a new episode of Universe. Hello, and welcome to Universe. This time, we'll be exploring the farthest planet from the Sun, Neptune. Let's start looking at the Sun, and then we'll zoom out from the solar system. Let's look from the window. While we zoom, I'll teach you a quick way to remember the names of the planets in our solar system. You can use a mnemonic to remember the names. My favorite one is My Very Elegant Mother Just Served Us Nachos. There are lots of other ones, though. Oh, and here we are, Neptune, the eighth planet from the Sun. It's also my favorite planet because it was not discovered with a telescope, but with pencil and paper. In the early 1800s, astronomers carefully charted the path of Uranus as it slowly made its orbit around the Sun. They found that it was not precisely what they'd predicted it to be. The difference could be explained if Uranus was being tugged by the gravity of some unknown planet even farther from the Sun. More than 60 years after the discovery of Uranus, mathematicians calculated where this new planet should be. When astronomers turned their telescopes to that part of the sky in 1846, there was Neptune.
Let's go outside now. Now that we're on Neptune, I want to talk about some of its statistics.
Neptune's diameter is 30,776 miles. Neptune is 2.7 billion miles from the Earth. If you weighed 100 pounds on Earth, you would weigh 114 pounds on Neptune. The average distance from the Sun is 2.8 billion miles. 1 year on Neptune is 165 years on Earth. One day on Neptune is 16 hours on Earth. Neptune has 14 known moons, but it is suspected that there are more that we can't see yet. Neptune's atmosphere is mainly made out of hydrogen, helium, and methane. The methane makes the planet blue. Neptune is named after the Roman god of the sea because it is blue. Like all the other planets, Neptune turns on its own axis as it is orbiting the Sun. Imagine walking around a large pond but turning round and round as you go. In the same year that Neptune was first seen, 1846, its first moon was also spotted and named Triton. It's strange because it orbits Neptune the opposite way that Neptune is spinning on its own axis, unlike Earth's moon. Try orbiting the pond again, turning on your own axis, but this time take a friend to orbit around you. If you are turning on your axis clockwise, have him go around you anti-clockwise. Be careful not to get so dizzy you fall into the pond. Triton is about the same size as our moon. Many more moons have been found since 1846, and most of them have been named after minor sea gods like Triton.
Oh, wow, it's getting cold.
Neptune has big differences in the surface and in the core. The surface can get to negative 392 degrees, and the core can get to 9,000 degrees. This causes the extreme winds.
Speaking of extreme winds, it's getting really windy. Whoa! Let's go back inside!
One of the biggest storms on Neptune was the Great Dark Spot in the Southern Hemisphere. It was about half the size of Jupiter's Great Red Spot, but a full Earth would still fit into it. Neptune's winds blew the Great Dark Spot west at 700 miles per hour. It was seen by Voyager 2 on August 25th, 1989. Recently, however, the Hubble Space Telescope showed that the Great Dark Spot has disappeared,
Scientists think that it has either dissipated, like our storms do, or is currently being hidden by Neptune's atmosphere. Voyager 2 showed scientists that Neptune had complete rings with bright clumps. Like Uranus and Jupiter, Neptune's rings are very dark and very faint. Scientists still haven't figured out what they are made of yet.
My oxygen tank is running low, but we still have one more minute to be on Neptune. There are some Neptune quiz sheets, space crossword puzzles, space word searches, and review sheets. Please hand me the review sheets and the quiz sheets when you're done. You'll get a prize if you get more than 7 out of 10 on the quiz. Now, back to Earth. This time, let's take the short way. A wormhole. Don't try this at home.
Whoa! Whoa!
And here we are. I hope you've learned a lot today. When you grow up, maybe we'll have the technology to send astronauts to Neptune. Wouldn't that be cool? Anyway, thanks for watching Universe. Tune in next time.
Next time on Universe.
Alpha Centauri is the brightest star in the Southern Centaurus constellation. It's the fourth brightest star in the night sky with a magnitude of negative 0.01. It is visible in the southern hemisphere and is too far south for most of the northern hemisphere to see.
Wow, this is really bright!
Funding for Universe is provided by the National Science Foundation, the National Aeronautics and Space Administration, the Corporation for Public Broadcasting, and from viewers like you. Thank you.